this video on time value of money, we're going to be talking about the second type of annuity, and that's an annuity due. And we're going to be specifically looking at the future value of an annuity due. This is where your rents or payments occur at the beginning of each period. Interest will accumulate during the first period, unlike it did in the ordinary annuity. So that's a little bit different. And the annuity due has one more interest period than the ordinary annuity does as well, because of that first period of interest. In addition, we're going to have to multiply the future value of an ordinary annuity factor by 1 plus the interest rate. That's because we don't have a table for future value of annuity due, and we'll see what we need to do with that here in just a second with an example. So you can see this on the timeline. Notice we're looking for that future value of this annuity due. Notice that we are making our payments or investments at the beginning of each period. Therefore, we will have interest in that first period, and there will not be a payment at the end of the last period, okay, because that would be an ordinary annuity. All right, let's look at an example here. So we have Bayou Incorporated. They're going to deposit $20,000 in a 12% fund at the beginning of each year for 8 years, beginning January the 1st of year one. What amount will be in the fund at the end of year eight? So if we didn't already know this, we would need to determine, is this an ordinary annuity? Well, first of all, is it an annuity at all? And then is it an annuity due or an ordinary annuity? Well, if we look at the problem, it says we'll deposit $20,000 in a fund at the beginning of each year for 8 years. Well, we know it's an annuity because we're doing the same payment for every period, for 8 periods. So therefore, it's an annuity. Is it an annuity due or an ordinary annuity? Well, remember, in the ordinary annuity, the payments are made at the end of each period. In this case, the payments are made at the beginning of each period. That makes this an annuity due. So what table do we use? Well, there is no future value of an annuity due tables. So we actually have to use the future value of ordinary annuity tables to solve this problem. So let's go look at that ordinary annuity table. And we know that our interest rate is 12% and we have 8 periods. So let's find that information. We're going to start with the 12% column and scan down to 8 periods, and we find the factor to be 12.29969. Well, because this is the future value of an ordinary annuity table, and we're looking at an annuity due problem, we're going to multiply that factor times 1 plus the interest rate. So we end up with 112% of that factor. So we end up with 13.775652. That's our new factor for an annuity due. And we multiply that times the amount of the deposit that we're going to make each year, that's $20,000. And we find that at the end of 8 periods, making our investment at the beginning of each period, an annuity due at 12%, we'll end up with $275,513 at the end of 8 periods.